if you are about getting more money to fix your bathroom,
right? That's what I want to discuss. You can get a lot of templates, a lot of credit repair
letters, free credit repair letters. But you all come on in, hit like,
hit share. Let me know if you can hear me on YouTube and Facebook. So there's many people who provide excellent information about fixing your credit. They provide information about 609 letters, dispute templates. They do a really good job. But 99.9% never talk about making more money, right? Once again, they never talk to you about how to get more money. Not trying to shoehorn your life into whatever you're making. If there's something you want, you go for it, right? So how does getting more money help you when you have bad credit? Now, here's some bad news. There are many people whose credit is just tore up on the floor, right? And you're looking at a 2 or 3 year journey into fixing their credit, right? I don't care if you have authorized users. I don't care if you purchase trade lines. It is what it is. But if you learn how to build your cash flow by learning how to leverage different things that I'm going to talk about that you're already using, even though your credit is bad, you know, this will help you fix it at a higher and better rate. Now, let's not get it twisted. You need good money. You need good credit, I'm saying, and more cash, right? I know a lot of people who have an 800-plus credit score, but they're not doing anything with their credit score. It's something called exposure limits. And we are on the eve of another recession. So there are some people who have great credit, right? But with the eve of the recession, your credit limit is going to be crammed down, and your credit card limit is going to cut you off. So if you have been using credit as an extension of income, then you need to understand these strategies and get real with yourself, right, of ways to get more money. Now, Dave Ramsey came out some years ago, and he talked about getting a second job. And people that did that then found out, hey, this second job, right, is getting me higher paying taxes. And so let's talk about how we can keep more money in your pocket or your purse where it belongs. So when you begin to learn how to get more money out of your paycheck, right, and put a significant amount of extra money into your pocket or your purse, then these are strategies that when combined together are very powerful of teaching you how to increase not only your credit score, but also your cash money or your cash flow. So often I ask people, what's your biggest expense, right? And how can I save enormous amount of money out of my paycheck? And a lot of people think their largest household expenses are mortgages. And when you sit down at the kitchen table to pay your bills once or twice a month, you think your bills is what you pay your housing, healthcare expenses, food costs, or transportation, ones I hear, most often. So are you sure that that's your biggest expenses? And the answer is no. The answer is simply taxes. Taxes is causing you your housing, your health care, your food care. The average person loses about 45% of income taxes, right, out of their paycheck. You don't forget state taxes, property taxes, gas taxes, Medicare, Social Security, a host of other taxes, right? And after paying those taxes, you know what you're left with? About half or sometimes even less than half of your hard-earned income to live off of. So after Uncle Sam has taken a lot of cash out of your wages, you have a very little to work with, which is your take-home pay. And now you only have about 20% of your hard-earned money to live off of, and that's why your pockets are empty, right? You're shaking the cash out of your pockets consistently, right? Good morning, Mr. Wheeler. Good morning, Jasmine. So most people will tell you to make more money, right? They tell you to make more job, send your spouse and your kids to work, borrow money, you know, try the lottery, but those are not attractive options. Downsize your lifestyle, right? Cancel your cable services, or maybe cut your own hair, or eliminate entertainment, right? Those are options, easy. Good morning, everyone coming in. But there's a better option, and it's a far better option. You want to know a secret? It's beginning a home-based business, right? You develop a long stream of residual income, and you become in control of your lifestyle.
And you know what?
The government, Uncle Sam, will actually pay you to start this home-based digital business. There is no cap on the income. But the important thing is it could qualify you for tax money that can reduce your paycheck of taxes up to 30, 40, or even 50%. Now you're bringing home more money out of your shit. Now I know you get our, and this is only available to home-based business owners. This is hidden information that most tax preparers are not aware of. Your cousin who do your taxes, your friend who do your taxes. But it's printed in black and white in the tax code, which means it's 100% legal and it's 100% audit proof. Why do a lot of people don't want to tap into this? Because they don't understand how easy it is now to keep the rep keeping. Because you only have to meet two requirements. Number one, you must work 3 to 4 hours a week, right, and attempt to run your business on a consistent basis like I do every day. The second requirement is to run your business with the intent to make a profit. You don't actually have to make a profit. Just the intent would do, right? So these are very, very simple requirements, and the average working American meet these requirements. And you know what will happen? It'll put about $5,000 cash or more in your pocket beginning today, beginning now, per year. And these tax incentives are only available to home-based business owners.